All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of In the Black TV. I'm your host, Matty D, owner of the site, getyourbusinessintheblack.com. I have a good host on today. I have Joe Stewart here with us. This guy is an author, done on Facebook. And Joe, how you doing, my friend?
Doing awesome, man. Thanks for having me on here. How you doing?
Doing good. I thank you for your time on this. Real quick, for those of you who are watching this the first time, you know what the show's about. It's called In the Black TV because it's all geared about helping you create a profitable online or offline business where, you know, when that happens, you have more financial abundance. What that allows you to do is then go on to create other abundance in other areas of your life. So we're all about creating more abundance here. So Joe, I was referred to you through my good friend Rocky, also known as the brand master here, who knows a lot of people who are successful, who are having success online, done some offline stuff. And you referred me to you, and I checked some of your things, and you definitely know what you're doing. So I wanted to interview you and see what, you know, what I can learn, what other people can learn from you, your experience, your wisdom, and just share, because we're always at a different point in our success. And the last interview, I don't know how long ago it was, you're at a different point, in your career, and who you are now at, you know, a different point. And I know you're working on a new book, so yeah, man. So let's start there with your story. Like, how'd you get involved with network marketing and back in the day? And how did all that happen?
Yeah, for sure, man. Like, I don't know, like 5 or 6 years ago, I was working in a department store, and, you know, with clothes and shoes. And, you know, I was customer service, helping the customers that walk in there. And I was in the shoe department, and this young guy, probably my age, a little bit older, approached me. And, you know, he was all dressed up with a dress shirt and all this stuff, and he was asking me questions about shoes and just asking me a bunch of questions about stuff. And then, you know, just the typical networker, you know, just, you know, ask people questions, get to know them. And, you know, he's like, are you open to, you know, doing some extra business? Or I forgot what he said. He's like, you know, are you open to extra income outside of this job right now? And I was just like, you know, yeah, absolutely. I was making minimum wage. So I was like, you know, heck yeah, man. He was like, you know, so we exchanged phone numbers, and he was like, I'm gonna send you a text message or something to send you my website with a video that you can watch. So I was like, you know, all right, cool. So I watched this video, and, you know, he invited me to some meeting, you know, and it was like an Amway meeting. So it was my first, you know, like introduction to like network marketing and MLM and stuff. So, you know, they showed the plan, and they were like, you know, it's $150 to get started. So I got, you know, I was like all about it. You know, I was just like, I saw my own business, like get my own website. You know, that's how they sold it to me. And, you know, so I got started with that. And, you know, I mean, they were, like I said, I found it through a meeting. So we were obviously taught to do the hotel meetings and meetings and, you know, calling our friends and family. And, you know, that stuff worked to a certain extent. But, you know, we did that for about a year and, you know, just learned the basics of network marketing. I really like the industry. I like the personal development. And, yeah, man, that was my introduction to the industry. It was about like 5 or 6 years ago. It was like 2009.
Okay. Cool. So you guys started with Amway and on there. You know, because everyone struggles a lot in the beginning. I have, we all have, you know, with that. Like, what were some of your biggest struggles when you got started, and how have those helped you to become more successful?
Sure, man. I mean, in the beginning, a lot of the struggles was just the rejection, you know, friends and family telling you it's not going to work, telling you, you know, go stick with college, you know, go get a 6-year 9-to-5 job, you know, don't do one of those things. So it was a lot of struggle with a lot of, you know, pressure from friends, you know, not to do it. But I was, you know, so that kind of sucked a little bit. But after a while, you know, I started making some money with it and having some good products to sell, and friends and family started to come around. I mean, there's a lot of other struggles too. I mean, just learning how to market, learning how to, you know, pick up the phone and call people and talk to them, and what, you know, what to say, what not to say. I mean, there's so many struggles to come over and, you know, learn from. Like you said, I mean, you learn from all of them. But yeah, in the beginning, I mean, I would say that was my biggest struggle, was just, you know, getting customers, getting the sale, and like, you know, just the whole thing. I mean, I struggled with everything, man. I mean, shoot, who am I kidding, man? In the beginning, like I said, man, I struggled on Facebook, I struggled on you know, videos, I struggled with the whole thing, man. And it's fun to think back, you know, it's just kind of funny to think about, but, you know, you learn, you read books, and you go to seminars, and you, you know, you start following different people on social media who are killing it, and, you know, you learn from them, and you kind of, you know, change up your style, and you just figure out what works for you after doing it, you know, trial and error, year after year, month after month, and you just kind of figure out what works for you, and, you know, just run with that.
Okay. Now, And guys, if you're on here, you got a question for him, please feel free to jump on. Definitely jump on, ask him a question, ask a question in chat. But definitely, while Mike's interactive, like I always say, get in and just ask the guy a question here. So, Joe, I want to ask you a question, man. When you were going through your times of your struggle and you had those moments of doubt, which you all go through as an entrepreneur, like you have days where it's just like the spirit of doubt really grips you really hard and you really think, man, I should stop. Like, what kept you going? And like, what would your advice be to someone who has that deep moment of doubt where they're like, I should just quit?
Yeah, I think everyone's going to have a different reason why to keep pushing when they're in doubt. I mean, mine was I just wanted to prove people wrong at that point. I had so many people telling me I couldn't do it. So just, at that point, it was just having success just to kind of say, like, I told you so, honestly. But everyone else is going to have a different reason, you know? I mean, some people, when people are doubting you, I mean, as I kind of lost my train of thought, but like, you just gotta keep pushing. I mean, you gotta, like they say with motivation, like you gotta plug into like the motivational videos on YouTube. That always helps out. It's just simple stuff like that, like just surrounding yourself with positive people, the audiobooks, the personal development. I mean, that's all the stuff that you have to do. I mean, nobody else can do that for you or help you do that. You have to do that on your own time. So you definitely gotta be, self-disciplined and motivated and, want change in your life, absolutely.
Okay, cool. I like the answer. You're right on that with, people. Basically, I think you'd agree that it comes down to you had to be self-motivated. Yeah, and Lee, you're right. Do everything as much as possible. So, awesome. You got some fans there. Now, you specialize in Facebook. Is that correct?
That's what people have told me. I mean, I guess. Man, I'll go with that. That's where I get most of my signups and customers, and my main, like my central nervous system or my hub.
Yeah. What do you think you specialize in? It's not asked that question. Well, that's what people tell me,
I consider myself a writer. I mean, I use Facebook as my outlet. Like I used to write on my blog and I had, I would get a certain amount of views every day, about like 100, 200, return visitors a day, which is good. And I still have my blog and stuff. I noticed that more people were reading my Facebook posts and I was getting more Facebook messages like, hey, I read your post or comment. So there was more engagement and more feedback on Facebook. So I was like, well, this is working better for me. I'm getting more eyeballs. More people are reading my content. So I'm just going to, stick with that. And, other marketers have done that too. I'm not the only one. I never thought to do that. I never thought to use my Facebook wall as like a journal or a blog,
Yeah. Okay. So, I haven't heard that before. That's interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's just how I look at it. I mean, I've heard other people talk about it like that. I don't even know if you looked at my blog, I probably haven't updated it in a couple of weeks or a month, but still a good tool. I mean, I still get leads from there. But like I said, Facebook was just more interactive. People would, comment or send me messages like, hey, I really liked your post or your status or your video or whatever it was that day. And, I was relating to a lot more people, just being vulnerable on Facebook, opening up to people. I think that's what people want. They want their authenticity and the realness.
Right. What do you feel people get wrong about, like when they're trying to market on Facebook?
Oh man. Well, I mean, so many different things to do wrong. It's crazy. Like, I mean, it depends. Some people want to just spam or just post their link all day or their product all day. Which, there comes a time and place for that. If people ask you for your link or your, whatever the case may be. But yeah, you need to talk about the product. You need to talk about the opportunity, but. At the same time, you want to focus on you. You want to focus on your people, your Facebook friends, and your following. What do they want? What do they want to see? A lot of marketers mess up. They're always just like sharing, like you know what I'm talking about. Just like the stupid, like the viral videos and the viral pictures, like in the dogs and the cats. And, like it's cute and everything, but it's just like, you know what I mean? Like people want to, marketers anyway, people who are actually looking to join stuff and buy stuff. Definitely not going to be posting some stuff like that. They're going to post value, inspiring stuff, inspirational stuff, training, more stuff like that. I mean, I try to be entertaining. I try to keep the people entertained. It seems that people like that and they come back to that. So, if you just make people laugh and keep them entertained instead of always trying to sell them stuff, you know, trying to sell them something and shove the stuff down their throat, people will just inbox you like, you know, hey, what's your link? I want to buy your stuff. You know, never talked to them before, never messaged them, never talked to them on the phone. So that's, you know, that's pretty cool.
Cool, cool, cool. Guys, hey, welcome to the show, Joba and Monique here. You guys have any questions? There you go. Ask Joe a question, guys. You got open. So it sounds like, you know, for along the way, and correct me if I'm wrong, you kind of accidentally discovered that Facebook is like your kind of like main go-to, your bread and butter. And it seems like that's really where you get out, because, like you said, you're a writer. So my next question for you is, like, why Facebook and not, like, do, you know, also, like, not, why not do mastering in, like, YouTube or Instagram or the other social media platforms?
Oh, man, I mean, it's a good question. I mean, I do use Instagram and YouTube. I'm not as active on them as Facebook. You know, I'll definitely admit that. But they're both, I mean, you can accomplish the same thing. I mean, I think with Instagram, it's more picture-focused. You know, obviously it's an image app. So it's like, I mean, I could, you know, I could make a really long caption or whatever, like, under the picture and use my writing and stuff. But I never really thought about that. I might do more of that. But YouTube, I mean, I you know, I have so many channels from over the years, man. Just, I mean, you know, old videos, you know, I'm still, that are just, you know, I don't even know how they're ranked. I just, you know, learned some SEO stuff, you know, years ago, and you just, you know, hope that it sticks. I mean, you know, back then, I mean, you don't know if you're doing what, you know, what works or what doesn't work. But,
right.
Yeah, YouTube's awesome. I mean, I like YouTube because people, you know, they really get to know you, they get to see your face, and they get to hear your voice. You know, with that, it's more personalized, like this, you know, getting to know each other and talk and answer people's questions. And Facebook, I feel that there's just more people on it. I don't know. There's more. I mean, YouTube gets, I mean, you could get unlimited views on your YouTube videos, obviously. But
yeah,
I don't know, like I said, I just after uploading, you know, hundreds of videos to YouTube and doing hundreds of Facebook statuses, I just had more feedback and more, you know, cash flow and leads from Facebook. So I just stick with what works for me anyway. You know, I mean, someone else might kill it with YouTube and they might not even have a Facebook profile. You know, there's a lot of marketers that don't even have a personal Facebook profile. They kill it, you know, offline, you know? So it's all about, you know, finding what works for you and just sticking with that.
Cool, man. Cool. We had a question from Monique. She asked, if you are a service provider, what is the best way to get sales and what are your thoughts on utilizing groups?
What kind of services do you sell? I mean, I would definitely do targeted searches, like, on the groups, like, whatever type of service you're, what industry you're in and what services you're providing. I would look that up, and, like, just add groups to the search and see if any groups pop up. And I would just kind of look through some of the people, look at their page, kind of see what they're about, the video production, editing. Yeah. So I would just kind of type those three things in, like coaching and the video production and groups, into the Facebook search bar and just see how many groups, what kind of groups pop up, kind of join them, look at some of the people that are in there with, you know, professional looking, you know, profile pictures, and they seem to be pretty active or, you know, authorities in those three niches, and, you know, follow them, engage with them, kind of get to know them a little bit. Totally. Yeah, I would definitely utilize that. I mean, that's with any industry, though. I mean, not everyone does the networking aspect like we do it, like talking to people. But I mean, at the end of the day, we kind of do, whether you do it over the phone or a Facebook group. I mean, what I do is I get the people from the Facebook group or from, you know, the Facebook chat, and I say, hey, what's your number? Or, hey, call me at, here's my cell phone number.
Right.
You know, so that way I have their phone number. And now it's, you know, you kind of got them off of Facebook, and now, you know, you can add them to your address book.
Okay. Cool, man. Cool, cool. This is good stuff. Let me ask you this. You know, the Facebook groups, from my experience, a lot of people on here have, I feel like the consensus is that they turn into just a spam fest. People go in there and they just pitch. That's all it is. And then if you do try and post something of value in there, like a blog post or something, like a video, that gets drowned out very quickly from all the pitches. Do you still feel that the Facebook groups are still a good place to post in certain ones, you know? And if so, like, how should someone go about, like, getting more contacts and leads from the Facebook groups?
Again, comments and stuff. I've never thought about using the Facebook group forum. I haven't really used the Facebook groups in a while, other than just kind of like meeting new people and kind of following them and chatting with them, just seeing if they're opening their talk and becoming friends. But what I used to post, I used to just post like my blog content from my blog, like any articles that I would.
Joe.
I used to post that. Get a little bit of traffic, but I don't know. At the end of the day, it didn't really seem worth it. Account flag, so I don't know if you guys know anything about that or have used that, but like Hootsuite or some stuff like that. I'm not too technical, guys. I mean, I'm good at Facebook and building friendships with people, but I'm not like a technical, like internet marketer.
Right. Hey, Joe, we kind of lost the picture.
You know, I like that.
We can still hear you though.
We can
see your profile picture, but we but you know we can still hear you though.
Oh, that's weird. Yeah, my webcam's on. Huh. I'm not really sure. Not sure what happened.
It's not a Florida connection, is it? I can't see you, but that's fine. Let's just keep going. We'll get things going for you. How did you get into writing? Or that did you discover that?
I was doing, I mean, obviously like in high school, I was writing like, you know, essays for teachers that I didn't really like. And, I started studying like MLSP and like Ray Higdon, and they were talking about blogging and stuff. So I started, I didn't really like to write, but I just started writing about like network marketing companies and reviews and, tips and tricks, you know, the whole attraction marketing thing. So after I had written like, you know, 300 articles on my blog, I was like, well, you know what? I was like, I have a lot of content on here. I was like, I might as well just write a book. So I just, you know, I just started on page one, and, you know, 6 months later, a year later, it was, you know, it's pretty much done. But yeah, I mean, I never really liked writing, but when I realized when I start, you know, when I write about stuff that I actually am passionate about and I like, which I like networking in this industry and getting to know people and teaching people about this and, you know, the benefits that I can do for them and their family. So I was like, all right, you know, if I'm passionate
right.
about it, and I'm knowledgeable about it, then I can write about it. But, so I think the blog was my outlet. Then I kind of switched over to Facebook, and then, you know, the book I published a couple years ago back in, I started writing it in 2011
and I published it
in 2012.
Let me ask you this, like, how has your writing influenced like your success with marketing online? Like, has it helped you out with like writing ad copy, or you just keep things like really simple, as you said?
Yeah, I mean, when I first started writing on here, I mean, I didn't even know what copywriting was, and then obviously, you kind of take some courses and you go to some seminars and you learn. You take on any type of clients, you know, social media or people on their websites. You know, 9 times out of 10, they're going to want copywriting or ask you about copywriting. You know, those are the highest paid writers on the planet. So, you know, I'm still kind of perfecting that. I mean, I enjoy copywriting. I kind of understand the basics of it, but I'm still learning more and more about that every day and how to, you know, use it for writing ads on Facebook. But, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of good products out there. I mean, there's a lot of good training just on YouTube. I mean, if you just go on YouTube and type in copywriting, there's, you know, hundreds of free videos. Or if you go on like JVZoo or, you know, any of the affiliate marketing companies, you know, there's a lot of great, you know, training and books on copywriting. But yeah, definitely a good skill for anybody in this niche to learn. You know, because if you're going to be putting out content on a blog or on your Facebook wall or in a book, I mean, you know, copywriting and the art of, you know, selling it, you know, selling your stuff through your writing. I mean,
yeah, awesome. I agree.
Best skill you can have, man.
Awesome, man. Have you done any Facebook PPC?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, I used to mess with it a couple of years ago. I mean, I still do it from time to time, like when I'm having events, like in certain areas. Like we're having an event for my primary company in Dallas next month in January. So I'm going to start doing some Dallas ads, trying to bring some people on board, getting into that event. Mainly just been using my personal profile. But I mean, you know, with you bringing it up, I've definitely been, we're trying to get back into using, you know, more PPC versus just, you know, the Facebook wall and your Facebook friends and Facebook chat and, you know, voice clips and stuff like that, you know, just for more leverage, you know, to get, send some people to the capture pages and get their name, phone number, you know, ask them some questions, and send them through a little, you know, like a qualifying process.
Okay. What would be your advice to someone starting out with paid traffic? My connection really bad, guys. I can't hear everything else. Hey, Joe, you still there?
What's up?
Yeah, I can hear you. Did you hear my question?
I was asking, what would be your advice
to someone who's getting into paid traffic or starting off with Facebook PPC?
Start small and kind of do some tests, kind of see what images work and what ad copy works. You know, try a couple different ones and then test it and then stick with the ones that work. Be yourself, in your ad copy. Always use a question, as your you only get so many characters in your title. Make it a question, for your prospect. Just target it, I'm not a master at Facebook PPC. I usually outsource, some of that stuff. But paid traffic, in the past, I've had success with solo ads, and I've had success with doing, little magazine ads. It depends on the person's budget. I think doing Facebook PPC is probably the cheapest in the beginning, and just like I said, scaling that from there, investing into different traffic sources.
Yeah, Facebook PPC is a good start once you get your account shut down, and then you're kind of back to square one again.
you gotta have other options.
So I was talking to a guy last week or so over on GChat, and he told me that I heard this from someone, I forget who said it, that network marketing is the highest skilled yet most underpaid industry. And why do you think that is, or what does that mean to you? Still there, Joe?
The highest skilled and most underpaid, and she said, but I don't know, the connection's kind of.
Hey, Joe, are you there? Okay, did you hear the question I asked?
Yeah, can you hear me?
I need to say it again. Okay, so really it was, I heard this from, I was talking to a guy on Gmail, GChat, and he said, your network marketing is the highest skilled yet most underpaid, industry. And my question is, why do you think that is? Or what does that mean to you?
Well, I think the income, solely relies on you. So, underpaid is really, depends on the skill. If talking to people is considered a skill, and, and talking to people, what does that mean? Facebook chat, phone call, a blab like this, writing a book, a YouTube video. You could talk to people in so many different ways. So, it's hard to say that it's underpaid. Obviously, if you don't put in the work, then yeah, you're gonna be underpaid. Average network marketer makes $100 a month or $300 a month, I think. That's the average, I believe. Somewhere between there. I'm not 100% sure. But you definitely have to be willing to put in the work. That's with any industry, though. Whether you're doing network marketing or affiliate marketing, you have to put in the work. You have to produce. You have to move product. So. If people aren't, that's the thing, you have.
Okay. What do you feel people get wrong about the industry?
If you don't learn the skills in the first place, you're never going to have any.
Say that again. I'm sorry. I thought you were done. It broke up again. Yep. Oh, man, my commission. Can you say it again? It kind of broke up a little bit again. I didn't hear the last thing
you said. But I was saying, you said, underpaid and the least, the highest skilled, but the most underpaid. But it's you have to learn the skills if you want to get highly paid. You have to read the books. You got to go to the seminars. You have to get in the trenches. And, you have to learn from experience. You have to learn from doing those three-way calls with your team, getting on those conference calls, conference call after conference call, Skype after Skype, you know, Google Hangout after Google Hangout. I mean, that's really the only way you're going to increase the skills. So, I mean, it's not everybody's willing to go through that. That's why, obviously, what is it, 97% of the people in network marketing, you know, they don't go full time, they fail. And only 3% of the people are actually, you know, doing the work and doing, you know, all the stuff I just talked about. And they're actually, you know, they're the ones that are getting paid, you know.
This is very true. And then the question I had after that was, you know, what do you think people get wrong about the industry when they've been in, and like, you know, why do people, you know, not really achieve the success that they want?
I think what happens for a lot of people is their sponsor brings them in with a lot of hype, and they're like, hey, you know, you're going to get rich quick. You just got to bring on, you know, 12 people and you got to do this. And then they have this high expectation, you know, and they're like, oh, they're expecting to make, you know, five figures, you know, their first couple bucks or a couple hundred bucks. And they're just like, very like, they're like, whoa, you know, this is not what I was expecting. But, I mean, you know, when people, so that's one of the things, people high expectations, but it depends too what they're teaching, you know, like when people, their first 48 hours of network marketing, you know, what is their sponsor telling them to do to get started or to help them get their first customers or their first affiliates? I mean, what is the income producing activities that they're helping them with? If you don't have a good sponsor and they're not helping you do anything like that, you're not going to make any money. And then you're going to go say, oh, this thing was a scam. You're going to go call your mom or your aunt and say, oh, I did a pyramid scheme, blah, 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 blah. You know, I didn't make any money.
Okay.
And, nice. So,
I think you're right in that. It's the expectations they get to set when someone gets started versus, you know, a lot of hype and it's easy and then they get in and then, oh, it's too hard. Yeah. It's like, well, yeah, it's life.
The reality.
So, you know, another question for you regards to social media. Like, what do you think people get wrong with social media? Because, you know, you and I see it when people, one thing is they spam a lot. And just what don't people understand about social media, and they make it more complicated than it really is? Because it's simple.
They try to talk too much about their products and their business. They don't, so, you know, they, like, I tell people, like, just again, treat it like a journal or like a blog or something like that, and just talk, just get to know people. You know, too many people are on social media just, and you can just smell the desperation from a mile away. They're just like trying to make money and trying to make sales, and that's good. Like, hustling and, you know, trying to make your money is good, but it's like, you don't want that all over your Facebook timeline and your news feed and stuff like that. You know, all that stuff should be done, in my opinion. Everyone has their own different ways, but you want to do it over like a private message or a phone call or a, you know, a Skype or a FaceTime. You know, that's when you want to talk about.
Okay, cool. Leah, how are you?
How are you guys? Hi, Joe. How are you?
That's where I think a lot of people get it wrong, is they just talk so much about their business and product that people don't get to know them. You know, people don't even know who they're buying.
Some lag here. We got
a little bit. My lag.
Joe, you still there?
Yeah, can you guys hear me?
Yep.
Yeah, I can hear
you. Yeah, Leah on. Leah's got a question for you.
Hey, what's up,
Leah? Hi, Joe. How are you? I was just listening to you. I think
you're awesome. How are you?
Thank you so much. I think you were spot on with everything you said. I just wanted to jump on and answer Matt's question as well. I think people forget to treat the social platform like a real entity. Like a real world. You got to go in, you got to make friends, right. You got to talk to people, you got to communicate, you got to show up, you got to say good morning when you interact and cross each other, you got to like each other and can be a part of the socialness and make it. I think that's the one thing that people don't do. I also think that they don't study the platform as much as they should. They should take like an hour or so and really just dive in and study it and test things and try things out. And one thing they miss on Facebook, I think that they miss, is to become whatever business they are entity when they're on Facebook. Because you can go on there and you can like other things that have to do with your product and everything that you're doing so that you can be in the community of what's going on. So if you're in fashion, you can go in and, you know, search fashion and follow all of those things. But you have to go look at that timeline as well every day. and see what's going on in that world of fashion or whatever business they're right. in. So those are just the things I thought that people were making a mistake on in their social media. But Joe, you touched on it, and you're so brilliant how you talk, and you just kind of let people do it how they do it. That goes far, and I can really see it in how you respond to Matt's questions about, you know, people just got to do it their way and be them, just like what you said. So I just wanted to hop on and say you're very correct and good questions, Matt.
Thank you.
Yeah, but I agree with what you said. I mean, like, it's like people, you're not just going to walk up to someone you see at the store and say, you know, hey, I have a business where you can make a couple hundred bucks a week. You know, you want my website? So it's like, why would you do that? You know, why would you do that on a social media?
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to jump off. I just wanted to say hi, and I'm going to jump off. Have a good interview, Matt, and thank you, Joe.
Thank you, Leah. You're awesome.
Yeah, thanks for coming on.
Cool. Yeah, awesome. I like it.
Yeah, she was, I wanted to touch on what she said. Yeah, I mean, the main thing with Facebook is just, instead of posting so much about, you know, you and your business and always being about you, you know, just go to other people's posts and just like and comment on those. You know, you see someone on another company and they rank up, you know, say, hey, congratulations, you know, keep up the great work. You know, you see someone get a new car, a new house, you know, say, hey, congratulations, you know, just always, you know, always be on other people's posts. You know, it's not always about your post and what's on your timeline. You know, you go on a bunch of other people's posts, and then that's how people find you and people, you know, friend you and follow you and message you. And, you know, you get your name and your little picture, you know, you leave it all over Facebook, and then, you know, that's how you build a following.
There you go. It's the social part that I think a lot of people forget. You know,
they just want to automate everything, or they want to skip the social part, but it's just impossible.
It really is. You're right on that. But yeah, you touched on, you know, you guys said it's studying one platform well enough where you kind of understand how everything works, kind of moving on from there. Yeah. Well, hey guys, thanks for the love. I appreciate it. And Joe, you're awesome, man. It's good to, I'm glad Rocky referred me to you. This is good. You have one book?
Yeah, thanks, Rocky.
Or is you awesome. One book out and you're working on another one, correct? What you told me?
Sorry, you broke.
Yeah, I was saying you have one book out right now and you're working on another one. That's correct?
Yeah. I put my first book out in 2012. It's called Create Your Own Economy. And then, I'm writing another one right now. I'm kind of like halfway done with it. And I will be finishing that up soon. And then kind of have to have some ideas put out for a cover. Have, you know, email my graphic designer and have that all done. And then, I'm hoping to put that out soon, probably early 2016, probably.
Okay.
I'm excited about
and
that.
The second book what's that one about?
It's going to be more about like more personal development, more like morning routines, life hacks. It's going to be more, more mainstream. It's not going to be, you know, I mean, it'll be perfect for, you know, network marketers, entrepreneurs, most of the people who follow me, but it's going to be more how to get in, you know, good daily routines, getting rid of bad habits, replacing them with good habits, motivational inspiration. It's going to talk about my story a little bit, kind of where I come from and some of the struggles I went through. But yeah, it's like I said, it's not done yet, but that's kind of the direction it's going in right now. It might be a totally different direction, but yeah, it's going to be a lot of personal development. But yeah, we'll see where it ends up, man. I still have a couple more chapters to add.
Okay. We also have a question from, I'm not going to butcher your name. I'm sorry. She's asking about the opinion on the Facebook groups. What's your opinion on groups on Facebook? Kind of answer, but you want to.
It's all good. Whatever industry you're in, like I do network marketing and direct sales and affiliate marketing. So I'm a part of all of those groups. So I'll go through them and I'll just look for people who look attractive, you know, like they have a nice profile picture, they have a nice cover photo, they look serious, they look professional, they have good posts, they have good content, and then I'll follow them, I'll like some of their posts, comment on some of their posts to engage with them. And I'll also, you know, scroll through the groups, you know, not just the members, and just see if people put out any valuable posts, you know, if they put out any training or if they put out just anything that I'm interested in, anything that kind of resonates with me or if it resonates with you, same thing. I'll just follow them. And it's all about just meeting new people in there and kind of driving them back to your offer, whether you're promoting your offer on your wall or your blog or your capture page, you know. So it's all about just getting them to your offer.
Cool. That's simple. What do you believe has, you know, helped you to become so successful? You're welcome. So lag, here we go. It's an awkward wait. See if you heard me. Huh?
Say it one more time, man. The questions keep breaking up.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna write it. And
unless you want to write it.
So, what do you believe has made you so successful?
Oh man, it's just being consistent daily. You know, just waking up every day and doing the things you know that you got to do. Like whether it's put out content or if you have a bunch of phone call schedules. You know, every day when I wake up, you know, my calendar has a bunch of, you know, beeps, you know, and different little X's and phone calls, you know, people I have to call, leads I have to follow up with. And, you know, some days I don't want to do those things. You know, some days I'd rather be at the beach or go fishing or go out to eat and, you know, drink or whatever and hang out. But, you know, you just have to do those things. So it's doing the things you don't want to do, being consistent, you know, even if you're only doing 30 minutes a day or an hour a day or 2 hours a day because, you know, you're working a job, you just have to, you know, you got to plant those seeds, whether it's through a YouTube video, a blog post, you know, sending out 10 or 20 Facebook messages, and just be real with people, be authentic. I think that's why I've, you know, sold copies of my book and built a little following on Facebook and online is, you know, I'm just real with people. I respond to everybody, you know, I've never let my ego get in the way. And, you know, I don't look at people like dollar signs, you know. Everybody, a lot of big internet marketers, you know, they're too cool to respond to messages and they're too cool to respond to comments, you know, and I'm not like that. I like to engage with people and get to know them. So I think that's what kind of sets me apart from, you know, some of the other people on there that are, okay, you know, trying to do stuff like that.
Yeah, you're right on the consistency there. That's very true. So your connection is like really not helping right now. We got a question though from, no, Chris, yeah, like it's breaking my mind too, but like I said, we're going to keep pushing. So I basically got what you said there, man. Just consistency and just planting seeds and just doing stuff, even when we don't feel like doing it, to help, you know, continue the success. Yeah. My girlfriend, non-performing, says you see that people appeal to you when they look good or professional. A lot of people on the internet in the internet marketing arena are very casual in their approach and look. What kind of suggestion would you have for them in order to visually appeal to new people on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Blab, etc.? Take a bath. Chris, you're funny.
Sure. I mean, I would still say what I said. Look at like Dave Wood, and he wears the tank tops and no shoes, and that's him. You know, that's his brand, and so he attracts that, you know, casual crowd, and that's cool. If you know, some people are going to have, they're going to want to, and you know, have the dress shirt and the tie and the suit and professional, you know, I would recommend anybody who's in our type of industry to have like a professional photo shoot. Yeah. Like they said, it depends on the crowd. You know, like if you're in a musician and you're in a band, you know, you're going to be all dressed up like a rock star and have your professional photo shoot. But, you know, if you're an author or a network marketer, you might want to have a collared shirt or dress shirt or whatever. But again, I would always tell people, just be yourself. Just maybe have a photo shoot done so the picture looks professional. If you have a product out, you know, maybe brand yourself, you know, with your cover photo, have your product on there to kind of let people know what you're about. And yeah, if you're a dirty hipster, I don't know, you might.
All right. Thanks for the question. Question. So I typed in the chat, just in case it gets awkward again. Where do you see your business in 20 years? Kind of far.
20 years. Now I don't know. I'll probably still be writing. Yeah, and I'll probably still be putting out books and doing like digital information products. I'd like to do like some live seminars, like speaking. Like I'm not really motivational. Like I'm just kind of like relaxed and laid back. But I still have a lot of knowledge that I'd be willing. You know, I'd like to teach people and get out there to the masses. I'll still probably be involved with network marketing. I mean, man, 20 years, it's a long road. I don't know. I mean, I'd like to get into a real estate. I mean, my dad does real estate. He's done pretty well with that. So I'd like to, kind of learn and take some of the money I've made from network marketing in my book and kind of, do some real estate. But hopefully, I don't know. I probably won't wait 20 years, but that's just what off the top of my head. Just, I mean, I love writing. I love network marketing. So, I mean, I don't see myself doing too much else over the next 20 years, but, yeah, definitely take some of the money and plug it into like real estate and
Yeah.
precious metals and just kind of
Good
diversify,
answer. I've never asked the question anyone. It's because usually it's always like, where do you see yourself in 5 years or maybe like 10? No one ever asks about like 20.
It's true, man. Yeah,
Five? I'm
usually
like
that's what
20.
I
You're like,
usually
well,
get
geez,
5 years.
I have no idea. Another question. If you're appealing to a more relaxed casual crowd, do you statistically find that the
Yeah,
casual
I'm reading
crowd
it.
join and drop off more frequently than those who aren't approached as casually by an internet marketer? That's a good question. Joe, did it break up again?
It's a good question. I'm not really, I mean. It's weird because I don't know, I kind of attract both people. I would say my Facebook right now and the way I'm set up is more like writer and guitar player and just cool guy. But I attract, that's the thing, a lot of the people I attract is the suit and tie crowd, and then a lot of the people I work with are guys who like to fish and stay-at-home moms. So no, I mean, I wouldn't say they drop off more frequently. I mean, it just depends how bad they want it. I have people from all different types of, casual or whether they're more relaxed, casual or professional, and they all, some of them want it more than the others, and they find success with it.
It's true. I agree. You gotta be on a
Exactly.
daily
Yeah, if you're
basis,
hungry, I mean,
hungry on a
gotta be
daily
hungry,
basis.
as Les Brown
Would
would
you
say.
agree with that?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Every day, man, you gotta wake up. If you're not hungry, I mean, go back to sleep. What's the point?
I'm gonna type this in here. Hey, Joe, what's your favorite personal development book or audio book or I'm sorry, book and audio?
What was it?
What's
You
your
said personal
favorite personal
development book and
development book and
audio?
audio?
How to Win Friends and Influence People's always been my favorite. I like a lot of Jim Rohn stuff. Just any of his audios on YouTube. I like to just go on YouTube and I put it on the 2x speed. You go to the settings and you put it on 2x, so it kind of he talks a lot faster. So just so I can breeze through it, and instead of watching two or three videos, I'm able to watch a bunch of them. So yeah, I like Jim Rohn audios. I like Zig Ziglar. Grant Cardone's
That is
The
a good
Connect
book. That is a good
audiobook was really
audio
good. I love
book.
that. A lot of great concepts on that book. Yeah, that was really good. But How to Win Friends and Influence People. I like Rich Dad Poor Dad. I mean, at this point, I would say it's kind of, it's for more. People new, just hearing about
Excuse
entrepreneurship, it's kind of trying to learn the difference between good stuff on YouTube or Audible.
me.
What was that?
Kind of broke up there again. I say, excuse me. Sorry. What's been your most embarrassing moment in your network marketing career, and what did you learn from that?
Most embarrassing experience from network marketing.
Yeah, and what did you learn from that?
Yeah, it's a good question. I think using a lot of hype, you're going to lose a lot of friends. And I think, I mean, a couple of years ago when I was, you know, doing some different programs, I'd use a lot of hype and a lot of like income claims and stuff like that. And I wouldn't really recommend people doing that. That was pretty embarrassing. Not embarrassing, but it's just, it doesn't look professional in my opinion. Like when I go to authors that I like and personal development guys that I like on Facebook or their social networks, you know, it's pretty professional, you know. It's a good, you know, yeah, there's not too much effort. I was doing another company years ago, and there was an Upline company, and I brought this guy to the meeting. This was when we were still doing meetings, and my friend was kind of interested, but he didn't have the money to join or something was going on. And my Upline went straight to his house or called him on the phone and was just like, "Hey man, what's your credit card number, man? Like I'll get you started right now." And it was just really like, 'cause it was one of my close friends. And that was super embarrassing, but then you kind of live and learn. Yeah, you don't. It's, I don't know. It's better, in my opinion, than not. Yeah, you don't. Yeah, you got to be careful who you work with for sure. But yeah, that was pretty.
That's crazy. How's this going for straight for the kill? Like, come on.
Yeah, like it's like, I mean, it was me asking my friend, like, "Come on, man, what's your credit card, man? Like, man, come on, man, you got gave me the green light, man. Let's get serious on it. Let's make some money. You know, that's different, but." Some random Upline that I just met like a couple weeks ago. Like, that's not cool, man.
Yeah, no, that's kind of overstepping your boundaries there. Wow. What drives you? I'm gonna type it in. Hey Joe, did you hear me?
No, sorry, the connection. Yeah. It's so weird. The
connection. What drives you, man, each day to keep going?
I mean, I think we touched on it before, kind of like since there's such a high failure rate. I mean, at least for what I do in the network marketing industry, I like to write and put out trainings and put out content that is going to help people, you know, get more customers, get more affiliates, you know, grow their network marketing business, grow their income. And hopefully, you know, they could take some of my advice, and, you know, if they're outside of network marketing, or, you know, maybe they're doing more affiliate marketing, or maybe they're just a mom and pop business. If they could take any of the stuff that I teach and scale their business, you know, that's awesome. So, just helping that 97% of the entrepreneurs that are failing, I hope that, you know, my books that I put out, the blog content that I've put out already and stuff that I'll add to that, and the YouTube videos that I've put out and I'll continue to put out. You know, I hope I reach a lot of people, and I hope I teach them some gold nugget.
I love that.
Or just some tactic that helps them, you know, get a new customer, or helps, you know, with all these online businesses and Amazon and Giants and Walmart and stuff. You know, I think marketing and teaching these local business owners, you know, real marketing and social media marketing, cool. You know, we could,
what that gets you in another
really
interview,
do a lot of good
when the connection is not so choppy. If you lost it all, if you lost it all, how would you start over?
Yeah, definitely not.
Really? Just.
Man, I'd pick up my phone and call 1,000 people. I'd join a network marketing business. Yeah, I would join a network marketing business. I'd find the best. Straight up, man, it's the fastest way. I mean, people could tell you anything else, but I mean, in my opinion, it's the fastest way to do it. Talk to 1,000 people as fast as you can. I mean, you can do it on Facebook chat if you want to sit there and send, you know, type out 1,000 Facebook chat messages or send out 1,000 voice clips. But if you get 1,000 people in front of your offer quick. You know, traffic. I mean, like you said, if you lost everything and you didn't have money for traffic, you didn't have you know, money for any of that stuff.
The hustle. Phones, I like it, man. That's the best answer I've heard. Like, no one's ever said, "Oh, I would do." Like, you're just like, "I'm gonna hit the phone." Like, people. I feel like, and tell me.
Straight up, man. Like, I got 2,000 numbers.
I feel like
phone.
Too many people are good or bad
as a network marketer, but I feel like that's a lot of people that I could call, and they're all moving. you know, my family and local friends and personal friends and stuff.
This is the truth. Yeah, what I said was, you know, I feel like too many people are afraid of the phone nowadays. Like, they're like, the phone, it's like, you're fine. You're not going to, like, get shot or something. But I used to be afraid of the phone, you know. But then you kind of used to it.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, it's like me and you right now, like, we're talking face-to-face, online, in front of people. It's like, you could do that, or you could talk on the phone where, you know, they can't see your face, they can't see your confidence level. Or they can hear it, like, you know, they can hear your confidence level, but still, I mean.
And wait for them to pull inside. I don't know. We'll try again at the time.
I am inside. It's just glass.
Joe, like, how do you want to be remembered, man?
Glass. Oh, man, it's a good question. I want to be remembered as, you know, I like making people laugh, so I want to be remembered. I don't know, man. I don't know if I want to be remembered as that writer or that Facebook guy. Dude, I'm not sure, man. You have to ask me again in 20 years. It'll be a different answer.
Broke a bear again. Thanks for the love, guys. Thanks for being patient with us on this connection here. It's too early yet. Yeah, it's too early yet for memories. You're right, but it's a good question to ask someone anyway because I always like to hear it. So, I guess Joe, you'll have to find that for down the road as time goes on. I'll definitely have to interview you again, man, when your book comes out, the second one, and you know, see what's changed and all that stuff. Though, definitely, man. I got my last question for you because I got to do a hangout in about 6 minutes to get ready for that. Is, you know, and I like this question. It's philosophical. Some people it's very simple. All up here, like, man, this is like deep. Exactly. It's who are you and what do you do?
My name is Joe Stewart. I help network marketers get more customers and affiliates in their business. Through
broke up again.
That I write. No, blogs that I write through my writing skills.
It broke up again. What'd you say? Joe, you there?
Yeah, did you guys hear me? Sorry.
What I heard was I don't know what else heard. Yeah, it was your name is Joe Stewart. You help network marketers get sales for the business and broke up. And I heard something about writing.
Yeah, I'm that guy that writes books about how to get better at life with personal development and life hacks. I don't know. We'll get more clear on that as time goes on. I'm still young.
Yeah.
Still kind of building my brand and figuring it out. But I'm at a good place. And I'm only getting better. I'm just getting started. I'll let you go, man. I know you're busy.
No, but dude, I got a few minutes, man. My girlfriend's right. She says, in a nutshell, he's a badass. End of story.
Hey, I'll take it. You know, badass. What's up?
There you go. Hey, Joe, what's the best way for people to get in contact with you after this? If you can hear me, type it in the chat.
Look me up on Facebook, Joe Stewart, or go to my blog, workwithjstew.com, with your own economy via network marketing. And I'll have another one coming out for you soon. Again, just follow me on Facebook and the book soon. And buy that one, buy the old one, buy everything.
Man. Yeah. Hey, Joe, put it in the chat because it broke up there while you were saying that.
Oh, yeah. All right, now, guys. Workwithjstew.com is my book.
Boom.
I'm writing the book, man. All right, I put two things in the chat box. Hopefully you guys can see it.
Cool. I see that. That is there.
Awesome, man.
Joe,
hey,
man.
Thanks for having me on your show, man.
Thank you for being on.
Appreciate it.
Thank you for being on. It's connections. It was terrible. So, but one last thing I got to do before I let you go, man. Everyone, give Joe some love. Thank you for being on here for that. my friend, you get the horn that I have on every time for everyone out here.
I love it.
There you go.
All right, bro. Have a good night, man. It was nice meeting you. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, everybody. For everyone else, find Joe, go to the site. Everyone here that wants to see the replay, I'll put it on my blog at getyourbusinessintheblack.com. And for anyone else that's still on here too, guys, I'm doing a hang-on training on how to get leads using Blab. I'll put the link in the chat here, and we go from there. And that's all I got, guys. Joe, again, thanks for being on. I hate the rush.
Have a good night.
Bye, you guys. Too. Everyone else, get in the black. Yeah.